The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
In every tiresome journey, we need a place for us and regain our energy. This is necessary if we want to continue our journey successfully. Sudha Murthy, in her anecdote, Horgelu, talks about a stone bench under the village banyan tree. People used to sit in there and refresh themselves during their long walks. They bless the Horgelu for being there. Like the physical Horgelus, people also need emotional Horgelus. The author's grandfather was such a one. Grandfather used to sit on the stone bench and listen to the problems of the villagers. This gave them the strength and confidence to continue their journey. This wonderful and meaningful anecdote, Horgelu, was written by Sudha Murthy. Sudha Murthy is an Indian engineer teacher and Kannada English author as well as a social worker. She is the chairperson of Infosys Enterprises as well as she is the wife of co-founder N.R. Narayana Murthy, who is the co-founder of Infosys. In this base of this lesson, we would like to interview our school counselor, Mr. Prakash. Mr. Prakash Paul, who took qualification in MSW, Master in Social Work and MSc Psychology. He also had a practical experience from Snehalem, Pondicherry by conducting street children's rehabilitation project for last 20 years before joining Gurukula.
Thank you, Vaishnav, for introducing me. I am so glad to interact with you all, plus two commerce students. I am thankful to our Principal Vijayan sir and Sri Priya teacher for giving such an opportunity to interact with you all and can talk with you all about the counseling. Thus, I can promote counseling in the society and in between you all. Some of us may mistake that counseling is just like advice, and it's a type of advice. But what is the case? Counseling is different. Most of us dislikes to hear advice. Why it is like so? Since advice includes some sort of criticism and domination. But in the case of counseling, the counselor will give equal respect to the client. Another case is, a counselor is a good listener first of all. Okay. After hearing all the psychological issues he facing, then only he starts speaking. Okay. And he will give some sort of solutions, way to solve the issue. And the client can select appropriate mode of operation to overcome his psychological issue. And the other case is about confidentiality. You can have any advice, or you can have appropriate advice from your close friend or close relatives, and your psychological issue may be solved at that time. But what happens in the future, there is a chance that the advisor can misuse the situation. Okay, I mean in future. And there is another chance that the advisor can share the same issues or the situation of the client to others, and those people may interfere in your life I mean the client's life, to make use of their own personal needs. So we can go through the counseling first. Counseling is the scientific method to assist a person to find solution to dilute or to close the psychological disorder he is facing. Okay. In counseling, there is a confidentiality. I mean, it is the psychological need of the client, and it is the professional ethics of a counselor that he should not disclose ever, never to anybody about the issues shared by the client. Okay, then. So, in this lesson also, there is a woman who is not that much literate, but she is hearing the problems of co-workers and giving a relief to all others who are sharing their issues with that lady. They are trusting that the issues shared by them will not reach to any other ears. That's it. So 50% of the psychological stress will be minimized by hearing. Okay. At a glance, a counselor cannot help to overcome the problem. A series of psychotherapy have to be done. In the case of counseling, the client will have a mental equilibrium to discuss about his or her issues and have the capability to hear what the counselor is saying to him. Okay. So this is all about counseling. I think you have understood about this, and we can go through the next question.
Hi, I'm Jain Varghese from Plus 2 Science. Sir, my question for you is, what is the difference between a psychologist and a psychiatrist? Can you make it clear?
Thank you, Jain Varghese, for asking this question. I am going through an example to distinguish between psychologist and psychiatrist. Okay, here it is, the example. Most of you have PC in your home, and the others may see. No, they have seen in the lab. In the last year, you have seen and you have used it. There are two type of parts. Okay, mainly I am telling. One is hardware and one is software. Here we can compare the psychologist as software service engineer, and the other, the psychiatrist, can be compared as hardware service engineer. We can see the hardware, but it is not possible to see the software. And the software I am telling can be compared to our mind of the human being. Okay. And the hardware is compared to the brain and the enzymes working in the brain. Okay. Then the psychiatrist is a doctor who can prescribe medicine to normalize the psychological equilibrium of a person. Okay, so it is a chemical and artificial equilibrium. It is temporary. Okay, and it is a platform to work for psychologist. Okay, you should distinguish in between this. And a psychologist will work for the client if he is having an artificial equilibrium. If he is violent, he can't do anything. Okay, that the client should share his or her issues, and the client should have a mental capability to hear his solutions. I mean, in psychotherapy, he should behave as a normal person. So, a psychologist needs the assistance of psychiatrist. That's the case. Okay. Nowadays, the main issue is between the psychologist and psychiatrist. They are like India-Pakistan war. Okay. Ego clash. Am I right or you are right? Like that. They are quarreling with each other. What happens? The client will be in roots. He cannot himself solve his issues without the help of psychologist or psychiatrist. So, in general, I am telling that psychologist and psychiatrist should work together with a unique mind to help the client. That's it. Okay. So, that is the difference between psychologist and psychiatrist. And the psychologist should not prescribe any medicine to normalize client's psychological equilibrium. Okay, I mean mind equilibrium. But a psychologist can do many things for the clients that he can attain, or he can help to attain the client to get bioequilibrium, which is permanent solution for his psychological issues. That's it. And it is with the help of psychiatrist. Okay. So together they can do better for the client. Okay. Hope you have understood all this.
Hi sir, I am Sailesh from Plus 2 Commerce. I have a question for you. Nowadays, counseling centers are like mushrooms. We can see it everywhere. How can we select an appropriate one?
Thank you, Sailesh, for asking such a good question. Nowadays, there are lot of counseling centers like mushrooms, as you said. Before going to a counseling center, we have to analyze what type of issues we are facing. Okay. Then, before that, we have to distinguish about the three levels of character. I mean, the character have three levels. The first level is the interaction with the society. The second level is the interaction with the family. And the third level is personal character. And the three levels, there may arise lot of psychological conflicts. In the case of social conflicts, I mean, if a person is interacting with the society and he is not ready to adjust with the society, the root of cause, I mean, the issues may be on the side of society or in the side of himself. That we have to analyze with the help of psychosocial counselor. I mean, the psychosocial counselor is the counselor who have the qualification of MSW, that is Master in Social Work. He can or she can deal the issues with the social issues and with the family issues. He is dealing or she is dealing all this when the psychosocial issue is mild. Okay. So, we have to analyze the type and the level of psychological disorder. There are three levels of psychological disorders. One is mild, moderate and severe. And the type of characters is social character, family oriented character and the personal character. So the second one we are discussing, what is it? The moderate psychological disorder. Okay, here it is little bit higher than the mild psychological disorder. For this we have to consult a counselor having a qualification of MSc psychology. Okay, this is the minimum level of qualification which the counselor should have. Okay, the third one is severe one, that the client alone cannot visit a psychologist or psychiatrist, since there are two levels of treatments he needs. He may be violent. Okay, then the psychologist will suppose to visit the psychiatrist first. He will suggest. Then after consulting a psychologist and he is transferring the case to the psychiatrist, the psychiatrist will give medicine to get a chemical equilibrium of the mind. Okay, then after taking medicine for some days, the psychiatrist will again check the normality, the artificial normality of the mind. Then he will send, if the client attains it, the psychiatrist send to him to the psychologist. So the chemical equilibrium, the artificial equilibrium which is not permanent, is the platform to work for the psychologist. The psychologist continues his psychotherapy. Okay, there are different type of psychotherapies like CBT, cognitive behavioral therapy, and like that. There are so many therapies. After the permitted or the suggested sessions of psychotherapy, if he attains, I mean the client attains the psycho status, what is the psychological equilibrium, which is permanent, that I am telling that it should be permanent bioequilibrium without the help of medicine. If he attains like that, the psychologist then again send him to the psychiatrist to recheck the equilibrium, the level of equilibrium. There the psychiatrist will check the level of equilibrium and give a certificate that he is normal and no need to take any medicine for this purpose. So these are all about the selection of counseling centers. Okay.
Hello sir, I just have this small question that I would like to ask. And people often have a misconception that those who visit the counselors are considered to be a mentally weak person or mentally sick person. But I believe that that is not entirely true, and those who visit them are looked down by other people. How can we change the attitude of people towards this?
Thank you, Hafiz, for asking such a good question. Here we have to discuss about our body first before discussing the mind. Okay, here how we dispose the waste of our body. One is we have to clean our skin first, so we will take bath. Then we can dispose the waste from our blood. that we can do the urine. I mean, we can pass the urine. Then the third case is about the digestive waste. Okay, that we will dispose in the toilets. Okay, so this is a mode of operation how we clean our body daily. But in the case of mind, is there any option like that? The impurities in our brain or impurities in our thoughts, what will happen? In nowadays, there are nobody to hear the mental agonies of anybody. So that's the case. A mechanical world going very rashly or rushing to achieve something. I don't know why they are running for like this. But here what happens? The daily waste is accumulating in our brain or in our mind. We have to service it. It's not a repair. The counseling is not a repair work. It is not a treatment. It is just like servicing the vehicle. You see, if we purchase a vehicle from a showroom, they will insist some services, free services. Is we are doing it when it is breakdown? No. We have to do the service as per the owner's manual. We will do the first service after 500 kilometers up to 750, then second, third, fourth, like that. Okay. Why it is like so? To continue the soft journey, I mean, we have to use that vehicle smoothly. That's it. So we have to do the servicing. So what about our mind? We are so concerned about our vehicles, but forget about the smoothness of our mind. So we have to service it. So it is better to consult a psychologist. For the normal persons also, once in a year, that's a better idea. Okay. Then the society will think that he is mad, since he is going to consult a psychologist or a counselor. If you are going to consult a physician, I mean a doctor, and you are meeting a person who is close to you, he will ask, where are you going? Oh, I'm going to consult a doctor that I'm not feeling well. Okay, you will disclose. But while if you are going to a counselor, to consult a counselor, you never disclose your psychological issues, since we will add the ego with the psychological issue. That should they think I am mad, or will they think I am mad? We are not ready to reveal our issues in front of them. Okay, so first of all, we have to change. The adolescent age people should change first in this modern world. The elders, we cannot blame them that they are prejudiced, that anybody going to consult a psychologist or psychiatrist, they are mad. But only we can do it. Okay, change the mind of the society. So if you are going for a consultation with the counselor, you have to tell, I am going to see a counselor since I have lot of issues, mild issues, and I have to train my mind, and I have to consult him to uplift my psycho status, to attain my life goals, like that. Some mind training program. You can also accompany with me, or you can take advice from the counselor. He is a good counselor, so that you can promote the counseling. So the misunderstanding about the counseling will end forever. Okay. I think all of you understood about the misunderstanding of the counseling of the society.
Sir, I'm Akhil of Plus 2 Commerce, and my question is, according to you, what would make an adolescent feel more content, sacrifice and happier?
Thank you, Akhil, for asking such a good question. How will we satisfy ourselves, or how can we make us more happier or content? That's the question. So first of all, we have to discuss about the adolescent stage. It is the stage of a child to transform from the child to the grown-up, matured person. It is from the 10-year-old to 19-year, okay, and 9-year period. In this, a drastic change of character reformation can be noticed. A great level of enzymes, hormones is taking place in action in our body, mainly in brain. Okay. So what happens? The severe fluctuation in mood changes is noticed. Then next is immature love affairs. If it is matured, doesn't matter. So it is an infatuation while seeing a complementary sex personality. Okay, complementary or opposite sex. That is, a male, when see a male, nothing happens. If he sees a female with same age group, it will change. He will feel some changes. Okay, that's quite normal. But how can we satisfy ourselves? We have to discuss it. If we are reacting very fastly, if an injustice is happened to us or to the others, we will react badly, that we have an adventurous mind. But without good thoughts, what happens? After the reaction, we have to regret. So in order to restrict the immature action, we have to attain lot of knowledge and good experience in our life. For this, better is reading than that of social media watching. The first thing. Then the other is meditation, yoga and floor exercise, like that. It will normalize our mental equilibrium. Okay. That we will get the self-control with all this. And if you have lot of energy and we are interested in martial arts, it is another source of attaining happiness in our life. Okay. Then in this pandemic condition, there is no chance to play outdoor. So we can do the indoor games. We can play the indoor games like carrom board, chess, ludo. Lot of games are there. The chess is a brain game. So that we can develop our psycho processing. I mean mind processing. Okay, we can develop it. Then the other case is, we have to intensify, we have to raise our immunity. For that, we should maintain the level of vitamin A, vitamin C, zinc like that. To get vitamin D, it is free from the nature. What is it? The sunlight. It is the best time, in the morning, from 7:30 to 9, if it is shining. If it is cloudy, we can't do anything. Okay, in this rainy season, it is seldom happens. The clear sky. Then next one is, after the sunset, we have to walk with bare foot in the wet soil. It will help to eject, or we can set out what our impurities in our brain, negative energy, which is accumulated by the continuous work throughout the day. Okay, this is one type of negative static energy. It should be passed through the earth. Okay, we have to lose it so that we can service our mind also. This is another option. Okay, then we can call our friends through video calls. Okay, we can call our teachers so that we can minimize our mental pressure. Then hear the music while we are going to the bed. Have the food at 8 p.m. and after 2 hours we have to sleep. Take deep sleep for continuous 8 hours. Okay, late night we should not sit in front of the TV. Okay, so up to 6 o'clock, 10 to 6, so we will get 8 hours good deep sleep, so that we have to fight against this COVID and we have to fill energy to work. Another thing is dancing. You can dance. It is possible in this pandemic condition also. So you see, lot of ideas I have shared to satisfy yourself. Okay. So hope you have understood all this.
I'm Adit from +2 Science. In this pandemic period which we are going through now, had create a big gap between a student and teacher. Sir, can you explain how it is possible to create an emotional intimacy between a student and teacher?
Thank you, Adit, for asking this question. Here, this answer is not for you and not for your friends. It is for the teacher. That the teachers should have a mind age which is similar to your mind age. That we have to discuss about what is mind age. We have body age and mind age. How will we calculate the IQ? It is mind age divided by body age into 100. Okay, that's it. So here, what is mind age? The age of the mind. Most of your teachers are 40 plus and you are only 16, 17, like that. What happens? They will react like a middle-aged person and you are in the level of adolescence. Then a communication gap or a generation gap will occur. So that the teachers should maintain their mind within the limit of yours. Okay. So a same wavelength can be identified. in between the teacher and the students. So treat yourself, I mean the teacher should treat himself or herself as a best friend of the students. Okay. They should feel feel that teachers is his friend or her friend, that he can disclose his mental agonies. The other thing is, if a teacher calls a student in this pandemic condition, video call, teacher is seeing that he or she is like a gloomy, having a gloomy psychological condition. She or he, the teacher, will ask, what happened? What are you like so? You can share anything with me. Why are you so gloomy, so moody? He can ask. The student will trust on his teacher. So, a intimacy can be worked out. Emotional intimacy. That's it. Then the other case, the second stage. You see, after completing the studies, you all will go on for searching a job, and after that, for a long time, you will miss your teachers. And if you come back to your native place, you will search, where is my teacher? I want to see my teacher. I have to visit my teacher's house. So that the emotional intimacy continues. Here, the beneficiary is teacher. In the jokes, the backbenchers says that the teacher should love us more than that of excellent students. Why? The most of the excellent students will go abroad by getting good jobs. I'm not distinguishing which they get is good and which the backbenchers getting is bad. I'm not telling like that. Every job has its own dignity. I'm believing on that. But once a backbencher is seeing his teacher in his old age, he will rush to help his teacher. Okay, so beware. The teachers should love more the backbenchers first. I am not making any conflict in between you all. I am telling the truth. Okay, so by thinking a teacher like a friend of a student, it is more appropriate to handle with them. Okay, I think you all understood.
I am Saurav from Plus 2 Commerce. As a student counselor, what have you seen and has the challenges of this adolescent age?
Hi Saurav, thank you for asking such a good question. Here we are discussing about the challenges which you are facing, I mean the adolescent persons are facing in their life. I have already discussed about the stage issues, this adolescent stage issues, that is the transformation period. Okay, the hormonic change. So the main challenge is to develop his or her own career. So we have to maintain or we have to fix our life goal first, then only we can hard work with an aim. That's it. The other case is, I have discussed about the love affairs, immature love affairs. It is a teamwork of our enzymes. We are innocents. The adolescent age personals are innocents. They are the work of love hormones. The main joke is, I'm telling that the same love hormones is the main resource to help us to study well. So what happens if a person falls in love, he loses his studies. So that is happening in several cases. You have a lot of energy within you. You can use it either in the way of negative or in the way of positive. Okay. So, the next we are discussing about the challenge is social media addiction. That's other case. You all know about this, so I am not going through it. Next is drug addiction. Okay. A form of sadism. Okay. We have to keep the mind. Once we fall in this drug addiction, it is not easy to come out of from that. Then other is fast reaction, an adventurous act. After this we have to regret. That's also we have discussed before. Okay. Then the other case is we have to maintain our equilibrium, mind equilibrium. So we should celebrate our life. Okay, there are several natural methods we have discussed. So we have to tackle how to overcome the challenges. Okay, I'm not going through all the cases, that our time is also limited. Okay, so these are the main challenges we are facing.
Hi, myself Aditya Menon. I'm from Plus 2 Science. I have a question to you, sir. It is common in the present generation to react immediately when they encounter an injustice. Is it right, or do you have any suggestion to resolve their issues?
Thank you, Adit S. Menon, for asking like a nice question. Here we are discussing about the fast action. Is it right or not? Okay. If we see an injustice before our eye, how we should react? Then we have to think that I have already said, thought without action and action without thought is dangerous. Okay, it is the reason for all the problems. So for good thoughts, we have to control ourselves first of all. And adventurously, we are jumping into more and more issues that it may cause our psychological disorder also. Okay. Sometimes we cannot get rid of from the issue we have involved. So we have to think first, is it good for me? Can I solve this problem of myself or the others? Then only we have to do. For example, you are seeing a man is drowning down in the water, and in your mind you have to help him, but you don't know swimming. What will you do? If you jump into the water, what happens? Two of them, I mean including you, will lose their life. Like that, we should not underestimate ourselves. There are lot of things to retain our energy, and we have to use it for good happening. Okay, positive attitude cases. Okay, the meditation, yoga, exercise like that, and the martial arts, all are good for controlling our emotions. Okay. So, in little cases, I'm telling that in little cases, we have to react first so that a good solution will come out from that. So, if we, the youth, will kept silent, what happens? The major part of the society will again and again do the wrong things, which may lead to a final failure of the old society. So, we are the persons to correct the dealings of the society. So, that's all for this question.
Sir, my name is Sajid KB. I am in plus two commerce. Sir, my question is, good friend or good counselor, which is better? What is your opinion?
Question, Sajid. Who is better, a good friend or a counselor? If a counselor is better than a friend, you have to go to the counselor. If your friend is a good counselor, you can go to your friend. So that's the case. And while discussing this, if your friend is capable to store your secrets, you can take his help to consult a counselor. Okay, that's all about the friendship and the counselor. All the cases cannot be solved by the counselor. Some of the cases can be solved by the friend, since he is accompanying you than that of the counselor. That's the case. He can himself identify the issues you are facing. Sometimes you better don't know what is happening around you, but he understood it well. So that's it. So we cannot omit the importance of a friend. Both are different manner in different aspects. Okay, both are important. We cannot replace a friend with the counselor or counselor with the friend. That's it. Hope you have understood about this.
Sir, I have a question for you. Having a mentor in life reduces mental stress or strain. How do you feel about it? Can you share your experience with us?
Thank you, Ashik, for your question. The mentor is a main person in all of us life. Mentor is different from psychologist. A mentor can consolate a person with his experience. That's the case. And he can give advice to rectify the psychological agonies of a person who is approaching to him. But it is not compared with the psychologist or action of the psychologist. It is different. I have told that a mentor can consolate. That's the main action he is doing. Oh, it will be all right. Don't give much attention for all these cases, and give advice, appropriate advice, to normalize his mental stability. That's it. So, mentor will help us in several situations. He can identify your problem without your help, so that he can understand it himself if he is closely watching you. But in the case of counseling or going to a counselor, when you tell the issues of yourself, then only he can understand and can give suggestions to rectify the issues. So this is the difference between mentor and a psychologist.
It's me, Arjun, from commerce grade. Sir, my question is, my previous generation did not have much dreams. They just led a normal life. But now, children and their dreams are so aspirational that their parents find difficult to cope up with their hopes. So they just feel disappointed and they just move out of the family circle. Sir, how can we bridge this gap?
Good question, Arjun. Here, we have to make the bridge in between our parents and ourselves. So what is the generation gap? We have to understand, or we have to discuss about that. In the childhood time of our parents, it is different from our level. They have their own decisions, and their parents, I mean the grandparents, will not interfere, or the case is different, that they are not capable to interfere. Most of them are illiterate. What happens? They have to come upwards with their own efforts, so that they have lot of bitter experience to become a successful person in their childhood and younger age. I'm talking about our parents. I mean your parents. Okay. Here, what happens at our stage? What happens? They know the struggles they have faced, and they are protecting us from all these type of struggles. So you people are not having that much experience. So you dream in a great level, but they are thinking practically, it will not happen. The boy or the girl is doing the daydreaming only. It will not happen. So that's the difference. How can we bridge it? That's it. The 50% of the issue is from the side of parent, and 50% of the issue is from the side of child. I mean the adolescent person. Okay. So both of them should come closer to feel like same level of personalities, same wavelength. So they have to interact with each other, with persons like having same mind age. We have discussed before in the case of teachers. Okay. So that you people can discuss with their problem, and they can discuss your problem. Like that, we can the parents and the child can come to a conclusion that we have to do like this to attain the life goal of the child. So nowadays, they are like enemies. By this, what happens? Lot of conflicts happens. The children will not obey the parents, and the parents give more care, and they are doing the pampering, and whichever he wants, the parents will buy and give it to them, and the children are treating the parents as a purchasing machine with ATM, that's all. There is no taking and giving in between them. So we have to go through all this, Okay. So I have told that we have to less the communication gap first of all. you speak with your parent with open mind. You have to maintain that type of level of speaking. That's the first case. Then sit together and enjoy like friends. Then only we can close this type of issues. Okay then.
Hi sir, I'm Sagar Sajit from Plus 2 Science. I have a question that children of my age have a common opinion that they are being pressurized by their parents to make their dreams come true. So sir, how to express our passion to improve ourselves without burdening them? Thank you sir.
Good question you have asked, Sagar Sajit. The pressure from our parents, what will we do? This is a very much important question in your life. They are misguiding us, misleading us. All time the quarrels are going on. And in this pandemic situation, we can't go outside. We have to sit inside the home with silence. What type of silence? You are not mingling with your parent. Here, we have to understand about the parent, and the parent should understand the feelings of the child. Child is not a small one. Here, it is a stage of adolescence, having 16 or 17 year old. So just like a matured person, he will act. So all the parents should understand one thing, that you are not the owners of your child. Then what is your role? You are the life trainers. A child should live in two families. One is the training family which he has born, and the other one is which he has to lead. He is the main person of the family later. So if he doesn't get any training from his family, the first family I am telling, with the parents, he will fail in his own family he is building up with his wife and children. So that's it. So give proper training as a parent to your child. That is your main duty, a life trainer. Okay. Don't try to pull him out and go through your ambitions. You may be a good doctor and you wish your child should be also a doctor. But the thought processing is different. You cannot misguide, mislead your child. That you have to keep it in mind. Then in the child side, I am telling that you have to respect your parents. And you have to maintain the clear communication with them. You have to respect them. And you should tell him about your wishes clearly. Clear-cut telling should be maintained. That you have to select your studies with respect to your inborn talents, so that you can enjoy your life and your job in your future. That's it. So the 50% of issues is from the child side, and the other 50% is coming from the parent side. So sit together and with proper communication, we can solve all these issues. Okay. Otherwise, both are agitated, both are having mental tension, and both have to consult a psychologist. So, cut off all these issues in your family. Celebrate your family with your parents.
I'm Akash and I'm from Plus Two Science. I would like to ask that children now try to relax only with media support. Is it a right healthy change?
Hi Akash. My name is Prakash and your name is Akash. If you are having an initial P R Akash, it will be same. Just I am joking. Now, your question is very much important in your life. I mean, adolescent age. You are using mobiles, I mean, social medias, all type of medias as a tool for relaxation. Up to a limit, it is good for us. Okay, mainly in this pandemic condition. Okay, we can't go outside and what to do for relaxation. No issues, you can use, but up to a limit, half an hour or maximum 1 hour daily, per day I'm meaning like that. But we have lot of indoor games also, we have already discussed about all this. Here we have to understand what are the issues we have to face in future. That's the case. It will adversely affect our brain, then our eyes, mainly not for the lens. It is badly affecting to our retina. That's the case. Since once the retina is get infected, you have to know that there is no medicine and there is no surgery is detected or develop up to this day. That is the case. So you should beware and you should love your eyes more than social media. Other case is the imbalance in our mental equilibrium. Okay, it makes the variations in our emotions. At last, what happens? We will become emotionless. That's the case. We have already compared the reading and social media watching. You know. Now, we can discuss about the addiction. We can develop unwanted connections with unknown person. What happens? There is a chance of misuse your personal belongings or yourself may be abused also. That's another case. Then we have to limit our viewing. I have said already half an hour or maximum to 1 hour. Okay, then we should not interfere badly, I mean, to produce fake news about the politicians, or in this pandemic condition it is offensible. And do not share if you are not sure that it is natural or original. Okay, so all this you have to think.
My name is Adarsh. I am studying in plus two commerce. Sir, I would like to ask you a question. Can you suggest some simple techniques to tackle over the stress?
Thank you, Adarsh, for asking this question. You need simple techniques to tackle your stress. Okay, then where the stress come from? If your dream and the reality is very much different, I mean the gap between the dream and the reality is so high, it is directly proportional to your stress also. Okay, then I am going to a quote, that is, feeling good or thinking good is easy. living good is also easy. Winning in life is so easy and so simple. But what is then the difficult thing? The most difficult thing is being simple. You should not give any big promises when you are in great joy. You are in a joy mood. Okay. And you should not make decision while you are in deep sadness or anger. Both will seriously adversely affect your mental equilibrium later. Okay. First of all, you think before action. Okay. We all have adventurous minds and blindly we will jump into the issues in which we are not that much experienced. Okay. Think positively always and think constructively, not destructive. Your thoughts should be constructive. Love everybody with your open mind, and that love should not be conditional. An unconditional love you should maintain every time. Okay. You should attain a type of love that you should understand the person's positives and negatives, and you love him as a whole. Okay, if he do well, I will love him. It's a condition. It will not work out. And don't keep it in mind the negativity of each person in your brain. It is like a psychopoison which will seriously affect your mind and body, and you become lose your wellness. Okay, so this is also a stress making source. So you have to think only the positive side of the persons. Here I am telling one thing, that always we keep good memories in USB or in album, and we will keep the negative memories in our mind. Just change the positions. Can you? Yes, I believe that you all can do it. Okay, these are the simple techniques. And reduce your media watching and the TV, late night TV watching, and the natural methods I have discussed before in some questions you have asked, your friends have asked already. Then all these are related with the simple techniques to lower your stress.
Hello sir, I have a question for you. Have you ever got burdened by listening to the problem of the clients? I know your answer is going to be no. Then how do you recharge yourself?
You have asked a good question, Akshay. And this is about me, the counselor. Okay. As you told me that it is certainly no. It's a big and blind no. Since each cases are a good experience, a different experience for us to deal the upcoming clients. Okay. We should be maintain a mind as a student till our life ends. Then only we can uplift our experience. Okay. Then only we can make ourselves as a very reputed, very experienced personnel in our profession. Okay. But we have to recharge ourselves. That a counselor should maintain or accumulate a lot of positive energy since he is giving it to different clients. So he has to accumulate. In the case of my personal life, I selected a place to construct my home in a natural beauty place. It's a tourist spot. A lot of film shooting have done. I'm telling about my location of my residence. It is Dhoni. Okay. Behind my home, there is a waterfalls in the mountain, and the mountain is very beautiful and elegant to see. Okay, a symmetrical session with what a beauty, I can't tell it in words. Okay, and the water coming from the waterfalls is flowing just behind my home, near to my compound wall. And I have steps to get into the stream. I daily take baths in it, and the water is with zero pollution since I am the first person who is living near to the waterfall. So it is a very good positive energizing source for me. The water contains Ayurvedic instinct since it is flowing in between 200 type of Ayurvedic plants. Then the other case is I have lot of pets and domestic animals like lovebirds, rabbits and cows, goats, then hens, lot of them I have, and the peacocks comes to visit my home, that I will keep some food and water at around the clock. Okay, so they will come and dance in front of us. So all this I am enjoying to accumulate lot of positive energy. So it is a God's gift also. Okay, all of us cannot get this opportunity like this. Then all these are the sources by which I am accumulating or recharging myself. Okay.
Sir, I am Abhi Michael of Plus 2 Commerce. I have a question for you. Do you think mere listening can solve all our problems? If so, what are the qualities of a good listener?
Hi Abhi Michael, you have asked a very good question. Mere listening cannot solve the problems. But by listening, the mental stress can be minimized up to a limit. Okay. What happens while listening? It is just like the clouds raining. Before the raining, the color of the clouds will be black. And you see, after raining, the sky will be clean. And the color will be in blue. Okay, it's a clean sunshine sky we can see like that. We can reduce the stress up to a limit. Then, the qualities of a good listener we have to analyze. We have already discussed before, but I'm telling little more different things about a good listener. A good listener should maintain a mind with empathy rather than sympathy. Okay. And the ideas giving to the person who is coming to speak their issues should be constructive. Okay. You should consolate the person who are approaching to you. it can do very much easily without solving the issue. Then you should maintain the confidentiality. Then the other case, we have to follow up what is going on in future also, so that they will open up their mind regularly, that they have the belief that he will take care of my issues with a long period. That's it. And it is more beneficiary for the listener also. If the listener is being having any issue, the persons who are approaching to him or she will also help him or her issues, to solve her issues. That's it. Okay, so mere listening will not reduce the problem, but reduce the pressure, mental pressure. Okay, this is a type of counseling. Okay, she is not giving any advice, but hearing patiently. The patience, that's a main quality of a listener, a good listener. Okay, so we are concluding this session, and I am so happy and I am so thankful to you all for joining in this questioning section. I mean, like an interview, I am enjoying it. This is a very good experience in my career also. Thank you all. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir, for your cooperation, and thanks for providing your valuable time with us.